some highway east of Omaha. You can listen to the engine moaning out its one-note song. You can think about the woman or the girl you knew the night before. But your thoughts will soon be wandering the way they always do when you're riding 16 hours and there's nothing there to do. And you don't feel much like riding, you just wish the trip was through.
Here I am on the road again.
G'day, Scott Wilson. I'm the president of the Eastern Goldfields Historical Society, based here in Kalgoorlie, Boulder. Our society's been here in the area since 1946, and we have over 120 members, and we're one of the largest historical societies in Western Australia. So our area covers most of the Eastern Goldfields, which is based to the east of Perth in Western Australia. The Italian community, they've had a great role to play in the development of the history here. And along with the Slavic community, they were very well known for hard working and workers on the mines, but also on the wood lines. So the wood was in great demand on the goldfields, and we had to source timber for the underground workings, and we also had to source the timber for the boilers to operate the steam engines, to wind the machinery, to run the locomotives, and to condense water, because there was very small amounts of water, only salt water. We need to condense it to get the fresh water. So the big influx, I guess, from the migrants was partly due to Herbert Hoover, one time President of the United States of America. He was working up in Gwalior, which is north of Kalgoorlie here, on the Sons of Gwalior mine, and he actually went out to engage a, he had Italian workers, and they did a very good job, and I think they put a few of the local British compatriots to shame, and they ended up, he said, well, I can get more of these workers, and they worked very well and started to show up. So it caused a little bit of tension in the towns, and unfortunately that boiled over in later years into what we call the race riots here, where there was a lot of blame and finger pointing directed towards the Slavic and Italian community for taking the jobs and undermining and undercutting. So the work at the Sons of Gwalior mine did cause a bit of grief because of the undermining and undercutting of the more, shall we say, English-based and local miners. So they were got their noses out of joint because of the work that was being done at a cheaper rate. And Herbert Hoover, who was working at the Sons of Gwalior, increased his exposure to the Italian population who was working there at Gwalior. So, yeah, but as I mentioned, the opportunity to acknowledge the hard work and the efforts done by the Italian community, Slavic community as well, because they were rightly or wrongly thrown into the migrant mix. So anyone who wasn't of a white Australian or English background were sort of thrown into that migrant mix. But the work they did in the wood lines was especially beneficial to the area, because they worked out in many areas in out from the goldfields, and established great communities and networks, and worked very hard into proving up and adding value to the gold mine. So very good profits were made on the back of the Italian community.